Hey guys, JNasty here. What is up guys? In today's video, I'm going to talk about some advanced warfare multiplayer concerns that I have from previous Call of Duties that could be in the next Call of Duty. Also, the gameplay you guys are watching is just some sniping gameplay, nothing special. Hopefully you guys will enjoy that, and let's get right into the commentary at hand. So first off, I would just love for this feature to be gone, but it is the join in session in progress, whatever on Xbox, where people can join your game and stuff like that. And if they remove this, it would do three things. One, it would remove boosting. Two, it would allow streamers not to be DDoSed. Three, it would allow streamers not to be trolled. That is just one of my things that I wish wasn't in the game. It would remove all those boosting, DDoSing, and trolling streamers, and I think it would be a really good addition to Call of Duty. No other games session joiners can affect you except for Call of Duty. Like in Battlefield 4, if somebody session joins you, you really don't really care because the map is so big and there's not a lot of bullshit like there is in Call of Duty. But anyways, let's get into the real info at hand. So first off, I think stealth perks are a little bit too overpowered. In the past couple of Call of Duties, Modern Warfare 3, Black Ops 2 wasn't so bad, but in Call of Duty Ghosts, it is really, really bad. So what do I mean by stealth perks? Like Assassin and Blind Eye, I really like the three perk system instead of all this point system like in Ghosts. In Modern Warfare 3, as you guys know, Blind Eye and Assassin were two different slots, and it pretty much made people undetectable on the map at all times. Same for Call of Duty Ghosts, people with incog and off the grid, and it just favors campers so much, and there's really no counter to a person camping their ass off like that. Now in Black Ops 2, they had Ghosts, where if you're moving, you won't show up on the UAV, but they also had the VSAT, which was too overpowered in my opinion, and it was just way too damn strong. And stealth perks are, in general, are really, really overpowered at the moment. What they need to do is they need to go back to the three-point perk system like they had in Modern Warfare 3, Modern Warfare 2, and put a Blind Eye and Assassin in the same slot. And that's just my thoughts on that. Also, add stopping power. Man, stopping power was the best. It just countered all that. So many people ran stopping powered over cold-blooded. It was insane back in Modern Warfare 2. Alright, so now let's go into something else. Let's talk about the maps. If you guys didn't know, in Advanced Warfare, there's going to be a double jump in the game. That is confirmed. Whether it be in multiplayer or not, I'm not too sure of. But if Advanced Warfare learned anything from Call of Duty Ghosts, is verticality in the maps is a bad, bad idea. Maps like Chasm, maps like, what other maps that I don't like playing? Stormfront, Siege is just way too big. Just so many maps that have really bad verticality in them, and they play extremely, extremely slow. You don't want vertical maps in the game at all. And if you're going to add some verticality to the maps, look at WMD from Black Ops 1. If you're going to copy any types of maps, do it from Black Ops 1. Black Ops 1 had amazing maps, amazing. WMD, Grid, Radiation, it even had Nuketown. Nuketown's not even that bad, but there's so many good maps in Black Ops 1. And what was really cool about Black Ops 1 and WMD is the main building, the middle building, was the power point to the map. You want to have power positions on the map, which promote people to move to that building, to take over that building, which in turn gets map control. You really want to focus on that. If you're going to add a lot of verticality to the maps, make it easy to kill those motherfuckers. Look at, what was that snowy map in Black Ops 1, where is that? They're all on that tower. I mean, there's no cover up there. They're easy to kill. Just do that. And also in WMD on that that tower by the building, I don't know what flag it is. I think it's the C flag. I'm not too sure. But there's that little railing that a lot of people like to go on. That was easy to kill as well. So if you're going to add some verticality, make sure it's in the open and make sure it's easy to kill those players camping their ass off up there. That is my big, big problem. Also, like I said, add some power points to the map. Make it in the middle, not in the back of the map. Look at maps like Drone, Aftermath. A lot of the power positions are in the back of the map with really, really long lines of sight. Take away those long lines of sight. Make those long line of sight coming from the middle of the map where they can't. I don't know what I'm trying to say here, but just remove those long lines of sight and just make a center point in the map that everybody wants to be in or around. Also, I want to go into spawn since we're talking about maps. I need to stop saying that, but Modern Warfare 3 had the best spawn system in the game. I really feel like it was a really, really strong spawn system. FFA, as you guys know, there is something called revenge spawn systems. A lot of people didn't like it, but I thoroughly enjoyed FFA in Modern Warfare 3. TDM in Modern Warfare 3 was perfect. I do not like TDM. Never have. But in Modern Warfare 3, it was really fast. It's a lot more fast-paced than any other Call of Duty out there, and I really enjoyed playing TDM in Modern Warfare 3, and I thought it was perfect. It was a strong spawn balance. Also, if somebody had the B flag, you spawned at the B flag. It gave you map control. That's what it should get. If you have the B flag, you should have that map control. If you have the A flag, you should just spawn there. If you have A and B, you should spawn on the BA side. That's what needs to happen, and it needs to be a really strong spawn system. It speeds up the game, it allows people to move a little bit better, and it gives a good, a player playing solo without a UAV up, it gives us a good sense of where the enemy is. In Call of Duty Ghosts, I don't know what the hell is going on. Even in Black Ops 2 sometimes, I have no clue what the hell is going on. But Modern Warfare 3 was just perfect, and I thought it was a really, really good game. Also, after talking about the spawn system, I really do like it, and I don't know if they should add this back. But if you guys know the spawn protection when you spawn from killstreaks, I think they should just remove that in general. You earn that killstreak, they deserve to die. That is what I'm thinking in my head. So anyways, let's talk about something else. Theater mode. Now, I don't know if they're going to have theater mode in Advanced Warfare or not, but if it fucks up the hit detection and it makes the hit detection really, really bad, don't bring it back. I mean, Modern Warfare 2 played amazing. Ghost has pretty good hit detection as well. And Black Ops 2 had the worst hit detection I've ever seen. And theater mode, they say it was theater mode, I don't know, but Modern Warfare 3 had really good hit detection as well. The theater mode was really, didn't work too well in that game, but overall, if theater mode does bring down the quality of the game, just don't add it. We have Xbox Ones, we have PS4, and I'm pretty sure you can record some of that, so please, 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 if it affects the game, don't bring it back. Also, I think something we can all agree on, every single player, is having a ping system on the console. There's a ping system in Call of Duty on the PC, and it shows how good your connection is to that host. So say you have a 20 ping in the game, and you're just destroying everything, or say you're that player like myself who doesn't have the best internet, you have 140 ping, and you go up against that guy that has the 20 ping, and you get shit on, and you're like, well, how? I shot him first, and then you see he has a 20 ping, and it'll just be like, wow, that guy's a fucking warrior. And then you can say that instead of blaming connection, and people can actually see for their own eyes that you're at a connection disadvantage, and I think it'd be a really, really good idea. The 3-bar, the 4-bar, the 2-bar, in Black Ops 2, man, I have like a 10-down internet connection, right? And when Black Ops 2 was released, it said I had a 4-bar to people in Canada, and let me assure you, I rarely 4-bar out of the country, or out of the state of Texas. So fake 4-bars in Black Ops 2, I didn't really like it, so I really would enjoy the ping system instead of the bar system, because the bar system is inaccurate as shit. And it's not a very good description of your connection to that host. You could be on a 4-bar and be at like 90 ping, and you'll still have a quote-unquote 4-bar. But anyways, I would really enjoy the ping system. Now let's talk about this. This was in Modern Warfare 3 and Call of Duty Ghosts, the support package. The support package in Call of Duty Ghosts is the best package in the game. You get a support mate, Oracle, ballistic vest, ammo crates. You get everything you could possibly want in the support package, and you can die and keep going on that streak. That's stupid. They need to just remove support. I don't like support at all. And I really, really feel that support should just be removed. If they're going to bring back anything, they should bring back assault and specialist. Specialist is such a good idea, and it promotes so much gun on gun. I hope they bring that back. I really, really do. Support and assault, two good things about Call of Duty. Support, not so much. Maybe if they change the support streaks to something else, I think it would be really good. But overall, support streaks need to go. And let's talk about specialist real quick. If you guys know, specialist got nerfed in Call of Duty Ghosts pretty hard. You don't get near as many perks as before, and in Modern Warfare 3 you got all the perks, and I don't feel like you're invincible with specialist on in Modern Warfare 3. I feel like you do have an advantage, but if you're rushing and playing the objective and all that, you really don't have that much advantage. If there's two players in front of you, most of the times you're gonna die. You're not some unlike super tank with juggernaut, stopping power, and all that stuff. You just don't have it. You have increased movement speed, and you just have a lot of the good perks. And a lot of the perks in Call of Duty are pretty worthless, so nerfing specialist does not make sense to me, and I hope they keep it like Modern Warfare 3 and the assault. If you want to make assault streaks really, really good, go for it. I personally liked them in Modern Warfare 3 without the spawn protection. I think they would have been perfect. I think Modern Warfare 2 streaks were really, really strong, and then Black Ops 2 streaks were really, really, really strong, and I feel like they don't need to be that strong. Promote gun on gun, and everything will be good. So since I'm talking about the kill streaks, I'm going to talk about, should we have a point system, or a score system, or like Modern Warfare 2 had it where your kill streaks go to your next streak. Modern Warfare 2, I did not. I liked how I could get a Harrier, which got me a nuke pretty much, but I don't think that is a good idea. Also, in Call of Duty Ghosts, the kill streak options, I don't even use assault in Call of Duty Ghosts because it doesn't make sense. But I really like the way kill streaks were set up in Black Ops 1. I thought they were really, really solid. You have to get 11 kills to get all the way to your chopper gunner or dogs or whatever you get. And I felt like that was the best way. Black Ops 2, yes, you got more points for playing the objective and stuff like that. But here's the problem with that. A lot of people multi-team hardpoint. A lot of those guys would get their streaks practically based off zero skill, especially when they're playing low-level players. You'll see them. They'll kill a guy, they'll jump in the hardpoint. Kill a guy, jump in the hardpoint. Kill a guy, jump in the hardpoint. And pretty much 5 kills and they already got their support. They got their swarm stuff in. It doesn't take any skill to do that. And I don't like the score-based stuff like that. I like the kill-based stuff, like in Black Ops 1. I think that's what they should go back to, is the kill streaks. You have to get all 11 to get your 11th kill streak. I think that was a really, really good idea, and I think that should continue in Advanced Warfare. Now, I'm just throwing out stuff that I personally enjoy. You guys might disagree in the comment section below, but I feel like this is what's best for Call of Duty. I've been playing it since Call of Duty 2, I think, on the original Xbox, so I've had a long time playing this game. Also, I want to talk about this. This is a big issue, and I always complain about this. It's called the headshot multiplier. If you guys don't know what a headshot multiplier is, it's where in Call of Duty you get extra damage to the head. So 2 shots to the head and you're dead. If you have a semi-automatic gun, it's a one shot. If you have a sniper, it's a one shot. And this needs to go. You can use it with snipers and stuff like that, but semi-automatic should never be a one shot kill. Assault rifle, submachine guns should never be a 2-shot kill. And if you guys don't know what view kick headshot is, I'm going to tell you guys what it is. So say you're shooting the guy in front of you. Say you're shooting him, you're putting shots into him, and he decides to shoot his gun. Now he's shooting at your legs, and all of a sudden you put some shots into him, and his reticle pops up to your head, pops up, and you die instantly because he view kicked headshotted you. That's why there should not be a headshot multiplier in this game. It should be removed, and I feel like the game would be a lot better, because a view kick headshot is a cheap way of getting a kill, and it requires no skill, it's mostly luck, and headshot multiplier should go away, but if you get a headshot, it should go in the kill feed, and I know a lot of the snipers would be happy about that, and I know a lot of red gunners would be happy about removing the headshot multiplier. Also, I want to talk about this, and I really, really, if you guys watch me in Black Ops 2, you understand that I hate this perk, toughness. Toughness in the last 2 Call of Duties have been a required perk. Required. You have to use them to win gunfights. Most of the time, you have to have them. In Black Ops 2, I hated it. I always run scavenger, and I lost a lot of 1v1 gunfights when I shot first because of toughness. So what they've done in the last 2 Call of Duties is that they made flinch really, really insanely, like, way worse than usual. And you have to wear this perk called toughness to actually combat in it and not have so much flinch. Which I think is bullshit, because it's a required perk, and I think they got rid of stopping power so that it can add more variety to the game, but toughness, you have to have it, and it's a load of shit. I hate the idea of toughness. You shouldn't have to have a perk to win a gunfight. If somebody shoots you first, they should win the gunfight 100% of the time, and that's not what happens in Ghosts and in Black Ops 2 if you're not wearing toughness. So you shoot them, and then they shoot you, and you don't have toughness on, you're going to miss a lot of your shots. So I think it's pretty troll, and I really don't like toughness at all. Now, here's another problem that I found in the multiplayer is pre-aiming. Pre-aiming is pretty much a no-skill way of killing somebody. You just ADS down one spot, and you wait for somebody to run in front of you, and you instantly kill them. I feel like pre-aiming, it promotes camping, and I feel like if they could do something where pre-aiming the bullets, if you pre-aim for 5 seconds or something like that, your bullets come out weaker at the beginning, and that will allow that player that is running around, moving around, some reaction time to kill that motherfucker camping his balls off, pre-aiming every corner. I feel like pre-aiming needs to be nerfed, and I feel like there should be some way to counter a camper, if that makes any sense. Like, the past couple CODs, or in every Call of Duty, mind you, it's really difficult to kill somebody that's pre-aiming and camping their balls off. I feel like something needs to happen with that, and I feel like something needs to be changed with pre-aiming. Maybe add some sway to it, I don't know. Just do something where campers have a harder time of killing people that are moving around. Now, this is my last thing that I'm going to talk about. I might have missed some. If you guys have any more ideas, throw them in the comment section below. That'd be great, but I want to talk about equipment. equipment in the past couple Call of Duties, Black Ops 2 and Call of Duty Ghosts, have been really, really supportive of camping. Bouncing Betty's, shock charges. Now, I'm going to talk about the difference between Modern Warfare 3 Bouncing Betty's and Black Ops 2 Bouncing Betty's, but shock charges, that was the worst idea I've ever seen. Shock charges need to go, and IEDs need to go. What they do is promote camping. They watch your flank. Somebody runs around that corner. You get hit with the shock charge. They know where you're at. Most of the time, they had a bouncing Betty, so you're taking damage from the Bettys, the shock charges, and what do you know? The enemy knows your exact whereabouts, and you're pretty much 1 to 2 shots, and they just kill you. And especially in Ghost, like you can dodge an IED, but that's not the problem. The problem is the enemy player that you're trying to sneak up on knows exactly where you're at, and you're one shot away because you barely dodged his IED, and he just kills you, and you can't really counter it. I feel like Modern Warfare 3 had a perfect equipment balance. Perfect. Grenades weren't extremely strong. If you threw it right on the person, you would get the kill. You could get multi-kills with grenades. C4 was fairly strong. I feel like it was too strong in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. Because it would go through flat jacket, but overall, if it didn't go through flat jacket, I thought it was perfect because you're giving up range when you use a C4. So a C4 should be stronger than a grenade, and I feel like it should be able to have a little bit bigger blast radius, in my opinion, because you're giving up some range on it. I felt like Modern Warfare 3 is perfect. The bouncing Bettys, you could easily dodge every bouncing Betty in that game. Stalker was a good addition where you ran past it, it wouldn't go off, and I felt it was a lot easier to sneak up on players even when they're using a bouncing Betty. Unless they had a headset and heard that their bouncing Betty blew up, they pretty much did not know you were coming. But with Ghost, the IED hits you, bam, they already know your exact whereabouts. But that's really all I want to talk about. Also, I totally forgot about this, is the target finder sights. They need to get rid of target finder sights big time. Target finder in Black Ops 2, and what the thermal sight. Even the thermal sight in Call of Duty Ghosts is pretty overpowered. It's a 1-point perk for a red dot and a thermal sight, and that doesn't add up. That should be at least 2 points. But hopefully they make it where you either choose thermal or you get a regular sight. No thermal and regular sight. Also, they need to remove target finders. Those things are so damn annoying and they're so strong, and I feel like that just promotes more camping because you can just sit there, pre-aim, and people will walk into your target finder, and it's pretty troll. Now, if I miss anything in the video below, guys, or in the commentary, make sure to leave a comment what you guys would like changed. I thought I covered quite a bit of it. I'm going to talk about snipers and shotguns and weapon balance in the next video. So if you guys enjoyed this, you might enjoy the next commentary topic as well. But hopefully you guys enjoy. I'll see you guys later. Thank you for watching. And this is what I would change with Call of Duty right now. If I had to choose anything real quick, I would choose a Modern Warfare 2 perk balance, removing Danger Close and Commando. And I think Modern Warfare 2 perk balance would be perfect. And then I would have Modern Warfare 2 guns with the kill time of Black Ops 2, if that makes any sense. Or Modern Warfare 3 guns with the kill time of Black Ops 2. Black Ops 2 has really good balance, but the damn hit detection is way off. They need to fix hit detection in general. Hopefully they get it like Modern Warfare 2. And yeah, that's really all I had to talk about. So hopefully you guys enjoy the video. I'll see you guys later. Tomorrow's video is about weapons in Advanced Warfare, weapon balance. So I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Peace out, Slapback. Motherfuckers.